It's Wednesday, but we're doing Tuesday tips today because yesterday I couldn't do it. So it was a little bit of Freaky Friday with Tuesday and Wednesday, and here we go. Today I want to talk to you about embroidery, which is my favorite craft. I'm going to talk to you specifically about designs and how to transfer them to fabric. I'm just going to show you a couple methods that I like. So this, I started by printing out this little robot that I drew. As you can see, fine arts are not my number one, but I'm pretty happy with this little guy. So, a great way to transfer this on the fabric is just to trace it. And I like to put it up against a window. Make sure you guys can see that, yeah. When there was some light behind it. And then if you're just gonna do it onto loose fabric, you can tape this up on top. Through there. I know you're pretty far away from me, but I can see that close enough. And you can use a pen, you can use a pencil. You know, I'm going to get a pencil real quick. I'll be right back. Don't go anywhere. Perfect. Got my pencil. So I'm just going to get up here, chase my little robot. Pencil's nice because transfers pretty easily on the fabric. It'll wash out. It'll also kind of fade as you stitch over it. It'll get covered. I kind of like a light gray design because then when you cover it with your embroidery thread, you pretty much don't see it, it disappears. And I'm doing kind of a messy job, so I don't want you guys to spend your whole day watching me. I know you could, but I've got other things to do as well, so this is what you get. Intricate design, something a little more complicated than my robot with the heart, you might want to get something like a light board, which basically would shine light up from below. That way you can do your tracing flat, which is a little bit easier than doing it upright like this. If you do this for a long time, your arm's going to hurt. There are a lot of commercially available light boxes. Another thing you can do that I have done before is use a tablet. And just turn it on, it shines light up. You can put your paper on top of that, and it shines right through. Sometimes I'll open a drawing program just as a white screen. I found that's really helpful too for smaller scale designs. As long as you don't press too hard, so you don't mess up your screen, but you'll be going through a layer of fabric and a layer of paper, so usually that works. That's a little hack for you. All right, so I have traced a little robot there, ready to stitch over. That in a hoop for now, and I'm going to show you another method that I like a lot, using an iron-on transfer pen. You may have seen, we reposted a video from the company Sublime Stitching that she did about her iron-on embroidery pen, which is great. So this you can use, you can print something out, or you can draw directly with this if you're good at drawing. And this has iron-on ink, so after you've drawn with this, then iron onto fabric. It usually lasts 2 to 4 copies, so especially if you're going to do something you want to make maybe a mini production of, you're going to do 2 or 3 or something, or say you wanted to put a design right here and right here on your shirt. This way you can draw it once and then iron it on multiple times. I took my little robot and I traced it with the transfer pen. I did it on the reverse of the printout because when you do an iron-on transfer, you need to do a mirror image. This is especially important if you have words. If you had a word here and you traced it with your pen, when you iron it on, it's going to be flipped. So I just like to turn it over and trace through the back. And what's nice about the iron-on pen is if you're doing a design on fabric that isn't nice and flat like this or isn't see-through like this, you can just trace on here and iron on. So for example, I have this apron that I made for work, and we had a class on this, and it's not flat, and it's also not white, so it's kind of hard to trace through paper onto it, but I can use my iron-on design. I think I will add my robot up here so I can have a robot over my heart. So when you're going to do an iron-on, you want to have a hot iron that is dry, no steam. So what I usually do, I make sure there's no water in there. There's some water in there. But no water in there, and I set it and I let it sit hot for a while, so that'll evaporate everything that's inside. I'm not too worried about those little drip drops. I think it'll be okay. Magic of live TV. We're live streaming. Anyway, so I'm gonna put my apron down here and figure out where I want my transfer to go. The first thing I'm gonna do is use my hot iron and heat up my fabric. That helps you get a better transfer. Got that heated up. I've got the transfer ink side of this guy. Put that down. And then what you wanna do is you wanna press firm and slow and just move from one side of your picture to the other. Push that down, and I've got my iron on the hottest setting. It's on the linen setting, and I've put it on dry so that any little bit of water in there is not going to come out the iron. So I'm going to push, just slowly move this across my drawing. I can lift up a little bit, peek, and see that my ink is coming through. So I know I've got my iron hot enough. Pressing hard enough. So there we go. Now I've got my little robot in there, and I can put this in a hoop and stitch it up, and I will have a robot for my heart. I've got one more thing to show you, one more embroidery tip. This is not about transfers, but this came up in my last intro to embroidery class, which I have another one coming up on Sunday, so if you want to come learn to embroider with me, go to crafthabitraleigh.com and sign up. But I'm going to show you a tip for when you are stitching on printed fabric. So, like me, I'm not a really good improviser when it comes to embroidery, so I like to always have a design printed so I can do it. But when you stitch, you always come from the back. And one thing that I found with beginning students is a lot of times it's hard for them to find where to put their needle through to get right on the line there. And here's something I realized I do, I didn't even know I was doing this, but you can take your needle behind your fabric and press, and you can see where that needle tip is before it actually goes through the fabric. So if I'm trying to get close to a corner, I'll come in and press until I can see, oh, there I am. Come up, and you're right on the right spot. So that's a little tip that will help you when you are embroidering on printed designs, and this tip will work whether your fabric is white or black or gray or colored, no matter what. When you're just sort of gently pressing your needle tip, you can see exactly where it's going to come up. And that's it. Those are today's pro tips about embroidery. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope that you will come embroider with us one day. It was my favorite. Happy Tuesday and Wednesday. I'll see you later.